the Philippine National Police looking into the alleged security lapses on the day Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo was killed. The PNP says it is searching for Degamo's five police escorts who did not report for duty on March 4th, the day the governor was gunned down.
We are calling itong five na personnel na sinasabi na security detail ni Governor Degamo. Likewise, we are also calling the PD and the regional director of PRO 7 to give us or to enlighten us on what transpired. Bakit nga wala sila sa during that incident na nangyari yung kay Governor Degamo.
Since Degamo's assassination, the PNP and the armed forces have set up checkpoints across Negros Oriental and deployed more troops to the province. But the AFP stresses there is no militarization in the province.
Dito makaramdaman ng tao na ang presensya ng sundalo ay hindi naman dahil sa maggulo, kundi para magbigay po ng kaayusan at tumulong sa PNP sa pag-implement ng batas.
A Philippine lawmaker implicated in the murders of several politicians extends his stay in the United States. Negros Oriental Representative Arnold Boteves Jr. claims he delayed his homecoming because of concerns for his own safety. Vivian Gulia reports.
The date is still uncertain, but Negros Oriental 3rd District Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr. intends to return to the Philippines to respond to allegations linking him to the killing of Governor Ruel Degamo. That's according to Teves's lawyers. But they say the lawmaker wants to ensure first his and his family's safety.
He's 100% willing to come back.
This week, next week?
Well, ang problema nga yung security. Eh. Kasi nga, pag titingnan mo, tinanggalan ka ng lisensya, kinasuhan ka for a 2019 incident, bigla kang renewed.
The Department of Justice earlier said that based on the latest information, Teves has left the United States for an Asian country. But his lawyers say, as far as they know, Teves is in the U.S. The travel clearance granted to Teves by the House of Representatives ended March 9th. Topacio responds to those telling his client that flight is an indication of guilt.
What is he fleeing from? Wala! Walang charge. There is no warrant. There is no indictment. Nothing.
He also tagged as hearsay a suspect's claim that Teves was behind Degamo's killing.
Ang sinabi nung isang taong inambush interview, may kausap daw silang middleman, ang pangalan ni Marvin. At sinabi daw nung Marvin, isang kong Teves ang nagpagawa. That is not a valid tagging. Hearsay po yun eh.
Teves's camp also denied that the lawmaker is in any way involved in the absence of Degamo's police escorts on the day he was killed. According to Topacio, they welcome an impartial House inquiry into the incident called for by Speaker Martin Romualdez. Topacio adds he is reaching out to Romualdez's office to relay confidential information.
We welcome that if the inquiry is going to be impartial. At least mga colleagues niyan, kilala siya niyan. We are already reaching out to the office of Speaker Romualdez kasi may mga pinaparilinga si Congressman Teves for his ears only. We have faith in the impartiality of Speaker Romualdez.
In a statement, Romualdez said he has yet to receive any communication from Teves since he appealed for him to return home. The House Speaker reminded Teves his stay outside the country is no longer authorized by the House of Representatives. He assured Teves that when he returns, the PNP is ready to provide security, an assurance echoed by the Justice Department.
He will be secured. He will be secured.
Teves's camp, meanwhile, slams the police raid on Teves's properties, claiming it did not comply with protocols and alleging that the firearms and grenades seized were planted. Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos asserts operatives observed SOP. The Pasha notes as early as January, Teves received information on a supposed plan to raid his house. At that time, Teves linked Abalos to the alleged plan, which the SILG called preposterous.
Pinipersonal na ako ni Benhur Abalos. Oh, may naririnig akong mga order na nagpapa-apply ng search warrant sa bahay ko at kung wala daw makuha, lagyan.
Ang importante rito, ayon sa ating mga operatiba na police, they followed all protocols dahil maingat nga kami sa technicality rito. No? Pabayaan mo ng korte ang humusga rito. What is important ay matugis ang mastermind nito ng mabilisan.
Davis's camp appeals to the Special Task Force and other authorities investigating the killing of Degamo to be fair and look at all possible angles. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
China's warning against the Philippines' decision to expand the coverage of its Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement with the U.S., drawing mixed reactions. Senator Francis Escudero slammed the Chinese government for interfering, saying the Philippines has the right to pursue a foreign policy that serves its interests. Senator Jinggoy Estrada, meanwhile, says pursuing renewed ties with the U.S. does not mean the country is waging a war against China. But Senator Amy Marcos can't help but being concerned that the Philippines may get dragged into China's tension with Taiwan. For Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel, there's a need to further study what's in the mutual defense treaty between Manila and Washington.
Tactics picked up from the Russia-Ukraine conflict to be practiced in the joint Philippine-U.S. military drills. The exercises kicked off Monday at Fort Magsaysay in Nueva Ecija Province and will run until April 4th. They are meant to strengthen the interoperability of Philippine and U.S. armed forces. Some 3,000 troops are taking part in these drills. The Philippine Army Chief says the training scenarios involve the defense of the Philippines from potential foreign aggressors. A court in the Philippine city of Navotas convicts a former policeman for the 2017 murders of two teenagers during the anti-drug campaign of then-President Rodrigo Duterte. Dismissed policeman Jeffrey Perez was found guilty for the killing of Carl Angelo Arnaiz and Reynaldo Guzman. Perez was sentenced to serve up to 40 years in prison for each killing. He was also ordered to pay $390,000 to the family of Arnaiz and $300,000 to the family of De Guzman. Arnaiz and De Guzman were reported missing in August 2017. The bullet-riddled body of Arnaiz was later found in a funeral parlor, while De Guzman's body was discovered in a creek in Nueva Ecija with over 20 stab wounds. In 2022, a Caloocan court found Perez guilty of torturing the two teenagers and planting sachets of marijuana and shabu on Arnaiz.
The Philippine government urged to provide compensation to Filipino comfort women during the Second World War. The Commission on Human Rights underscored the need to provide victims with full reparation as well as recognition, redress, and an official apology. That statement from the CHR comes after a United Nations committee said the Philippines violated the rights of victims of sexual slavery during the conflict by failing to provide reparations.